you to all of the Jaffa families and the Jaffa team. Oh, we're really missing you a lot. And we hope you're doing okay in this very strange time. Today I'm going to share a godly play story. A godly play is just a way of telling stories which helps us to reflect and think about the story and then wonder about the story. At the end of the story there are some wondering questions, and when you wonder there's no right or wrong answer. So if you're watching this with somebody else in your family, you might want to share your answers with them in the pause that will follow each question, or you might just want to think about your answers for yourself. So this is the story of the flood and the ark. When God created everything, God said, "It is very good." But people began to do bad things. God decided to send a flood of water to wash everything clean and to make it new again. Then God saw a good family. The father was Noah, and the mother was Naamah. They had three sons, and their sons had wives. Noah walked with God. God came so close to Noah, and Noah came so close to God, that he knew what God wanted him to do. God wanted Noah to build a big boat called an ark. They began to build the ark. As they were building, creatures came from all the four corners of the earth to fill up the ark. They came two by two to fill up the ark. when the arc was finished. All of the creatures were on the ark. It began to rain. It rained and rained. The waters came down from the heavens and up from the earth. At first, it was like any rain, but it kept on raining. Puddles began to run together, and soon the water covered everything. When the creatures on the ark looked out at the rain, all they could see was water. Rained and rained. It rained for 40 days and 40 nights. But God did not forget about the creatures on the ark. After 40 days and 40 nights, the rain stopped. God sent a great wind to dry up the water, and the water began to go down. Noah took the dove. He held it carefully and then sent it out. It flew and flew. Noah held out his hand to receive the dove. There was still nothing but water. Noah waited 7 days and then sent the dove out again. It flew and flew. This time, when the dove came back, it had a fresh olive leaf in its mouth. Now there were green and growing things on the earth again. Noah waited 7 more days and then sent the dove out again. This time the dove did not come back. It found a home and made a nest and stayed there. The water kept going down until eventually, finally, the ark came to rest upon the earth. All of the creatures began to come off the ark. They were so happy to be home, they just couldn't help it. had to say their prayers to show just how happy they were. Built an altar to show just how thankful they were. Then suddenly all the creatures looked up and saw a great bow in the sky, a bow of many colours. Today when we see rain and the sun is shining, we see a bow like this. We call it a rainbow. The rainbow was God's sign to say that he would never flood the earth like this again. And then all of the creatures went out into the four corners of the earth to fill it up with life again. I wonder what part of this story you like best. I wonder what part of the story is the most important part? I wonder what part of the story you are in, which part is about you? I wonder whether there's any part of the story that we could leave out, but still have all the story that we need. Well, you can carry on wondering about the story if you want to, by making a piece of art or doing some writing, or perhaps you want to get out your Bible and have a look at the story again for yourself. Thank you for listening, and we'll see you again soon.